Hare Krishna. Materialism reduces organism to mechanism. Materialism is the ideology that matter is all that exists. And this ideology, it leads to a very dehumanizing, depersonalizing view of life. So, for example, it reduces people to their physical structures. We are all organisms. But materialism reduces organism to mechanism. Mechanism is that which simply functions according to mechanical rules. So, mechanical rules are, say, the laws of mechanics, the laws of physics. They do act on our bodies, because our bodies are made of matter, but we are organisms. We are not made of matter. That which is simply mechanical, that does not exhibit consciousness. And when consciousness is present somewhere, then that also leads to manifestation of certain distinctive things. Matter comes into existence, it deteriorates and it gets destroyed. Whereas living beings, they come into existence, they grow, they maintain themselves, they reproduce, then they deteriorate and they are destroyed. So, organisms exhibit reproduction, growth, maintenance, which mechanisms don't exhibit. No matter how good a robo we may make, the robo does not reproduce in itself. Robo doesn't do things, doesn't exhibit consciousness. So, we have to understand that our bodies are mechanisms. All living beings have bodies, and their bodies may work according to mechanical laws, but the living beings themselves are not mechanical. There is something beyond the mechanism that animates the mechanism, and that is the non-material essence. That is spirit. The Bhagavad-Gita urges us to look for the spiritual beyond the material. In the 13th chapter, it says, sanjayate, that we see that all living beings are, all of existence is a combination of matter and spirit. That there, beyond matter, there is spirit. Yavat sanjayate kinchit sthavara jangama evacha, that there is sthavar and there is, that there is kshetra, there is kshetragya, there is matter and there is consciousness. So, materialism sees the mechanism but doesn't see what is animating the mechanism, and that is the blunder of materialism. So, by this wisdom of the Bhagavad Gita, we can see the limitation of materialism and see beyond the mechanism to the conscious being. And it is that conscious being that seeks happiness. It is that conscious being that can find happiness when the consciousness rises above materialism to spirituality. And in the realization of our spirituality, in the realization of our connection with the Supreme Spiritual Whole, is life's supreme fulfillment. Thank you. Hare Krishna.